The who is Ash's father theory is one in the Pokemon series that still has yet to be solved without question. While many other theories have been proven either canonically with supporting evidence or through science, Ash's father is still unknown. But before we get into that, I wanted to say thanks to all my patrons for helping me continue and improve this series. And if you'd like to contribute for just $1, you can see these videos one day early. But if you are an interested in patron, but still want to contribute, check out the community shirt store made exclusively for my community of subscribers by my community of subscribers. Now, let's detail and discuss all of Ash's fathers. Ash is an interesting character that is to represent a young kid going on a massive adventure, exploring and discovering the world. Within interviews from the creators of Pokemon, many characters in Pokemon represent the creators' experiences and imaginations as children. They wanted to give the same experience to the children of today as well, but because the cities built up around them, the country-like areas of those regions disappeared, and with it, their childhood, I suppose. So the next best thing would to have someone experience that world through a magical artistic representation, a TV show, or a game. Thus, Ash was born to go on amazing adventures, never getting into too much trouble that he couldn't get out of, and at the end of the day, he always did what was right. If this character truly reflects the creators as children, then we already have the answer to who or where Ash's father is. But let's look at the contestants for today. Professor Oak is one of the leading theories on being Ash's father, and while I understand it's pretty easy to assume since two people often spend a lot of time together, they are or may have been together. However, Delilah's husband being still around, alive, then Oak would be doing something very dishonorable with her, to commit adultery. And while we don't know the age of Oak, we do know that he is probably significantly older than Delilah. While this could all be deterrence, it's not a 100% negative outcome, but it's highly unlikely that Oak is Ash's father. Not only for those reasons I already listed, but while Professor Oak is helpful to Ash, he certainly didn't save back a Pokemon for when Ash was late, unless you count the unfriendly, hard-to-handle Pikachu. Pika.
It's also known as Electric Mouse. It's usually shy, but can sometimes have an electrifying personality.
I see what you mean.
Shocking, isn't it?
Giovanni is the next one, and I think this comes from the fact that a lot of people think Giovanni is Red's father, and that also there was once a play that stated Delilah Ketchum used to date Giovanni. Now keep in mind that plays are non-canonical, otherwise yes, Giovanni would be Ash's father. But for added dramatic effect, plays often rely on emotional responses and relationships to drum up tensions. In the anime, no. Giovanni encounters Ash and doesn't really even bother with him as he is preoccupied with other things at the time. And Mewtwo, being a psychic Pokemon, would have read Giovanni's mind before escaping, learning how to become a Pokemon trainer, but also learning all of Giovanni's secrets. So when Ash first encounters it, it would have used this knowledge to manipulate him more. All in all, Giovanni seems highly unlikely. The final potential father is someone known as Silver. Silver from the anime, not Silver Giovanni's son from the games. This is because his hairstyle is the same, which I personally do not see that as a reason, but also because he is a brash trainer who has a Pokemon that isn't held in a Pokeball. And when another trainer mentions Ash, he reacts to it.
It's just like this friend of mine, a Pokemon trainer named Ash.
Ash?
Yeah. He's got a real one-track mind. We're both pretty stubborn.
However, looking at many other characters, we know that many trainers keep Pokemon outside their Pokeballs, like Misty and Togepi, Richie Sparky, and Ash's own Pikachu. And there are plenty of characters who are also brash as well. As for his reaction to the name Ash, you can think what you want of that. But his character was written for a small subplot to teach people that they shouldn't battle each other if they are not both at full strength. If you'd like to see the episode episode itself. The name is The Search for the Legend. I assure you, it seems to be a one-off episode used to push the idea that Ash learns to do the right thing from other people. And no, I do not think Silver, an honorable man, would know of Ash and then shirk his duty as a father. No, Ash's father really is gone. In Japan, much like in America, to be involved with video games is to be a loser in regards to a job. That was the attitude in the 1970s and 80s. Many people viewed video games as a toy for children. No real career path would be found there. They would die out like a fad. And the video game crash of 1983 also reinforced that notion heavily. But the creators of famous video games and systems all usually had fathers and mothers that did not approve of their potential future in that field. Satoshi Tajiri, his parents regarded him as a delinquent when he was younger, and they thought he was throwing away his future. Shigeru Miyamoto was Satoshi's mentor because his father could no longer teach him the things he needed to learn going into the video game industry.
Mad Proto, how does this all show that Ash's father was gone?
Many Japanese fathers of the time were gone. Whether it was hard physical labor or in an office, they would be gone. Even today, many Japanese men will sleep in their offices from working so many hours as opposed to going home daily, meaning their families, if they have any, they wouldn't see them. In my own personal experience, when someone is working 80 hours a week, you don't see them. And if the creator of Pokemon is anything like all of the people who had their fathers gone, then it is likely to impact their creations as well. How do you design a father if the character is you and your father is too busy working all the time to be around you? One final piece of evidence is that in the second episode of the show, Ash is told that he is the apple of his father's eye and that he is following in his father's footsteps. Just taking the fact that Ash is doing the same exact thing as his father was doing, then his father is more than likely still gone. Ladies and gentlemen, you can be the judge of whether Ash's father is one of the three aforementioned characters or if his father is just a man who is too busy with work to see Ash. Please remember to sign in to like and share this with other people. I have been your host, Proto Mario. I'm signing out. Thanks for watching. Shoutouts to OG Mavericks. And as always, good gaming and God bless.